Welcome back to another one of these Carbonite Ultra U videos. We are going to look at connecting to an Abacus, Tria, or Mira server, how to set up the device, and how to work inside of dashboard and the new workflows. So let's go ahead and hop right in. So here we've got our Tria Explorer open, and we opened up our engineering setup. First up, we come to the RS422 tab. One thing that's kind of unique about the Mira servers is you can actually associate channels with rooms and that a different configuration per room. Take some channels, associate them with one switcher, take some channels and associate them with another switcher. It's really kind of neat. We're gonna stay with one room, so channel A and B are assigned to room one. And we want amp over Ethernet for our Ultra to talk to it. I don't have to worry about this. Video effect, don't have to worry about that. Amp protocol, disable field timecode reporting, allow overlapped commands, allow playlist control, because we want to be able to queue and play playlists. Inhibit file extensions. We don't need to worry about the file extensions. It will just work. So we go ahead and it will restart the Tria service. Everything is found, life is good. While we're here, let's go ahead and set it up so that the Tria will be able to accept Tally. Now, one piece that isn't very clear is you do need to set up a label. If we don't set up these label names, well, it has nowhere to put the Tally data. So I've named channel A server 1, named channel B server 2. Now I go over to the Tally information. Now I don't know if the actual IP address matters, but I put the IP address that's coming from the Carbonite. I set it up for 5728 because that's the port I decided to use. And I chose TCP server, which even tells us use this with Carbonite. The switcher is sending the data. So it's going to connect as a client to the server, which is receiving the data. I'm going to make sure that I'm TSL UMD 3.1. Right tally lamp is preview, and preview color is green. I do want to support green. This is based how you have your inputs configured. Now, ironically, clip 1 goes into input 15 on my Ultra, and clip 2 is in input 3. That will tell it what it is listening to. We are good to go. And if I select one of my server clips in preset, you see that it lights up. And if we select the other one in preset or preview, it lights up. So the Tally data is already set up and running. I did set it up on the switcher already. We're gonna flip on over and go through those two steps next. We're in dashboard and we're using the virtual panel. Now, if you have a physical panel, you can do the same steps on it. I'm gonna go ahead, hit menu, system, next, next, device config. As if from scratch, we're gonna add new slot. I'm gonna put this to slot 10, and the type is serial tally. There is only one subtype, that's TSL UMD. I'm sending it to the server IP address. And like we said, 5728. Now, for options, transport type. Well, we're sending via TCP IP. The label, do we want to center it? Now, sending to the Abacus servers, so the Trias and the Miras, they don't actually replace the names. They just use it for the Tally data. So whether it's centered or not is irrelevant. I won't send the frame sync label. I won't show the bus name, show UMD ID, don't even need to show that. Now, 1 second update. This can reduce the amount of data that is being sent to the Tria, and so that initial update may not be taken. Now, anytime something gets an instantaneous item, it will send that update and interrupt it. So we're going to go ahead and we're going to enable 1 second update just to kind of slow poll it. We're going to click OK and we're going to confirm. And so that's all we had to do to enable that TSL UMD. So if we cut over, we can see that that is up and running just like it was before. Back to dashboard, and let's go ahead and get our amp devices set up. You know, menu, system, next, device config. We're going to go ahead and we are going to add a new device. We'll put it in slot one, and this is going to be a server. Click next. We've got our amp type. We click next. That's the IP address. The port is 3811. That is the default port. That is what Abacus uses and the Trias and Miras. We made it possible to change the port for other servers. Pre-roll. I'm going to go ahead and give it like 5 frames. Eject clip. Tria servers, they don't want the eject command when you're queuing a clip. Just send the queue clip and it'll take care of it. That way they can't come out of order and cause a weird queue, then eject. We set that to off with Trias and Miras. Those are your settings. We go ahead and confirm that. Now what we need to do is jump into the config menu, jump into input, next to bring up our device assignment. Clip one, select the device. It's the amp device. Click next. Channel. This is channel one, no other options. And we're going to go ahead and confirm that assignment. Then we go down here and there's clip two, select its device. Channel two and confirm. When we look at live assist, we should have, there you go. We're seeing the clip IDs showing up inside of the menu, and we can queue, we can get a clip list. You can see all of those clips. We could queue our clips, we could play our clips. Now with it queued up, with roll clip enabled, you hit the cut command and it's going to send the play command, but after 5 frames. But wait, there's still a little bit more. One of the awesome things that was added with the Trias and Miras was their OGP gateway. What we need to do for it is similar to how we added any of our other devices. We want to come up, hit the plus key, and it's a standard device. So you come into Open Gear Dashboard Connect. So switchers, servers, they all fall under Dashboard Connect, TCP IP device. We'll give it a display name of Tria. This one is JSON 5254. Finish. And now we've got our Tria device in the list. And when you go ahead and you click on Explorer, I've now got access to my Tria Explorer, to my Tria channels. I can go ahead and I can grab a clip. I can queue that clip. The clip queues up. I see it's loaded. I come to this clip. I queue up that clip. Just like the Tria Explorer, I hit play and all of that is running. When you come back and you jump over here, you could see that that is controlling it via dashboard. So you can install that anywhere you need. The only difference is you won't get thumbnails of the video clips. Let's go ahead and let's tie this into our Carbonite Ultra switcher. In that same way that we set up our other devices, we're going to go into our configuration. We're going to go to Live Assist. I'm going to go ahead and I am going to put Tria. And now we're going to go ahead and we're going to add our Tria control. And what you'll notice is in Tria, we have an extra Explorer Touch. So Explorer Touch was added so that it fits into this screen a lot cleaner and gets you 2 channels per tab. We've got that assigned, but remember, we got to go back to the inputs page and then associate our channels, channel 1 and channel 2, with the Tria GUI. When we head back to our live assist, anytime we select one of those channels, we're gonna get that GUI popping up. The channels get spread out based on the number of tabs and channels. I've got that UI, I can click, I can grab even a playlist, and I can go ahead and I can queue, playlist is on air, I play that, and now I've got my playlist and I've got all my counters. Very unique in the fact that we were able to configure both device control for our clip players and being able to set up that TSL UMD tally so that now a server operator right there in their interface is going to have status of what channel is in preview, what channel is on air. Very easy to keep track of. So that had a lot of information about how to configure the TSL addresses for preview, which is pretty cool, alongside, of course, the standard setting up of an AMP device to be able to control it from the switchers. You want to be able to also, you know, play around with custom controls, see how you can insert queuing of clips. There's a lot of value in that. And those things we'll look at in a separate video, of course. Now, hopefully you also saw how unique and cool it is now that Abacus has the Tria and Mira inside of Dashboard as well. Putting it inside of those custom pages, allowing you to basically bring that user interface directly into your switcher, is really unique. And as they add more features to the dashboard interface, you won't have to wait for a switcher update because it will just instantly show up. That's the power of custom pages. As always, thank you for watching this video. If you have any comments, questions, recommendations, please send those over to switchers@rossvideo.com and we'll get to them as soon as we can. Have a great day.